Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome to round two of Race to Right. Whoa, no, bucket it up already. RFGRC or Gentlemen's Racing Club for round two of season 12 here at Poznan in Poland. The last track. Robert Kubica drove on before he smashed it into a tree. Buggered up his chances of being a Formula One champion, potentially, amongst other things. Although, to be fair, he shouldn't be allowed to be gardening anytime soon. Today, we've got three rounds of high-octane action. 11 laps or 20 minutes around this fast, but still very technically challenging circuit. Complete contrast to last week's, which was very tight, twisty, very claustrophobic. Here we've got open grasslands, fast speeding and sweeping turns, but there's a lot of strange cambers and gradients into some of these corners, and the way how these BMWs seem to handle around these circuits, it's almost like they're all being set up to be tilting into the corner as much as possible. And a lot of people throughout this practice session I've just been watching for the last hour or so are really finding the limits and far beyond the limits of the tyre grip capabilities around here. Now we're just going through the pre-race briefing. Big crowd here today. We had 27, we're now up to 29 drivers here for today, so not everyone will score points this time round. Much larger field spread though here. I'm seeing gaps of up to 10 seconds between first to last. We're just moving forward to qualification in a couple of minutes time, and then after qualification we shall go through things such as the positions of the championship order after the first round. Of course, three races of 11 laps or 20 minutes, whichever kind of happens first, is what we're looking at today. You can join us here on Simrace.TV Stream 2's chat box, where I see we're already joined by Alex Cooper. Hello, Alex, mate. Hope you're doing well. And I'm sure, just as last week, there'll be plenty of banter to go on. A lot of people have weights. Weights is also a big theme here at GRC. When you do well in one race, you'll be penalised for it the next. 35 kilograms has been popped on our championship leader, Martin Acidnovas. Bonus Ball Yarrick has 30. Emmanuel Gaczela, 28. Martin Palm, 24. Rono Muru, will be room, 14. Randy Muru, 9. Adrian McNaughton and Paul Joseph both have 1 kilogram apiece, which is about, well, a curry's worth. Mind a kilo of curry. We're just moving forward to the qualification. Lots of people. Everyone's trying to get out already by the looks of it, as the green light drops and Acidnovas and John Gibbons and Tom Ely all battling to try and get out of the pits. This isn't like a 2 minute hot lap. I've not seen that before at the start of a GRC qualification lap. Gibbons, yeah, it does remind me of that actually. Cameraman extraordinaire Simon Malewicz also behind the scenes just saying to me, it's like when, do you remember when they used to have to burn off fuel on that final 15 minute session or 20-minute session of Q3 back in the 2006 regime of Formula 1. Loads of people out. So Gibbons, Dave Robertson, new guy for Team Core, out there. Stephen Boniface is out there. Mike Ward, Paul Joseph and Stuart Fleming. There's loads out. I'm really surprised with that. And surely they're all going to have to now start finding their own space. And there was quite a big field spread beforehand. There's a welcome to chat room, Ricardo Helston. Nice to have you there, mate. Everyone's going to start buggering each other's laps up. Tim Spur, Mark Jones just joining the track, as is Adrian McNaughton. They've waited for the initial offset, basically, before taking to the track. But I can see Jan Hack and Barry Ward are catching up for Stuart Fleming, who's been towards the back of the field here in practice. And if they don't pass him before they get to their hot lap, it's going to be a real problem. People are actually physically overtaking each other on these hot laps, trying to jostle for position. Not what I would personally have done myself. So, the man that won out on that drive out of the pit lane is our championship leader, Martin Acidnovas, and he's just coming around the final corner to start his hot lap. Let's just see exactly what this course is like. He's driving out onto the grass there down the home straight. That's not the fastest way to get round. Closely followed in his wheel tracks by John Gibbons. Down into this deceptively fast first corner, 180 degrees round, slightly banked to your advantage, I feel. Or it just feels that way when you drive round it. Round the kink of turn three there, I think it is, before we start getting into the tighter infield section. And you can really see the difference between here and last time out, which is barrier heavy claustrophobicness. Here, oh, you can see the back end just slipping out slightly there for Sidnovas, who's a bit wobbly on the exit. One corner very much leads into the next, and if you screw up one, you're left trying to catch yourself back up again, or you're just losing straight line speed down the straights. There's a lock up there for Sidnovas into the second half of this lap coming up now. Attacking the curbs quite nicely. Once again, GRC rules, you're allowed to have tyres on the curbs, but you're not allowed to have all four wheels over the white lines that define the black stuff and the tarmac. Do that, and well, you might get spanked a little bit by me. So here we are into the more tighter and twisty circuit. I've seen many people going off around that quick chicane there and then overshooting it round this. Behind Sidnovas, Tom Ely has caught John Gibbons, and that's now affecting both their hot laps as they're almost battling for position. Sidnovas, though, pace setter in practice, pace setter last time out, winning two of the three rounds, coming out of the final corner to set the time to beat with 6.5 minutes left to go in this Q session. 1:44.629, provisional pole position there, quite nicely set up there. Tom Ely, 1:45.562, held up by John Gibbons, who now slips to fourth as Reno Maru goes into fifth, half a second behind Sidnovas. Barry Ward does very well to go into fourth, just ahead of Paul Joseph. Done a great 1:46 there. Jan Hack slips in for eight. Ilja Brachalo is stuck behind everyone as Anthony Jones spins out the final corner. He was slowest in practice and he's going to not get back on track. He's found himself behind the barriers. Brachalo ends up fourth, followed, stuck behind traffic as Robertson goes in 12th, 10.7 seconds away from pole. Did Anthony Jones complete the lap? No, he doesn't. He goes back into the garage and that's that. Mike Ward and Paul Huggett just crossing the line. Where do they end up? Mike Ward goes 9, Paul Huggett 13th, beating Dave Robertson there, so good stuff, a scout for the Hugmeister. Who else is going round? Martin Palm, still going for Tyrannus for IP Forge, round the last few. Who's that just popping in closer to the top? Tim Spur goes 4th for Psycho Racing, so good form book there for him. Martin Palm runs out wide onto the grass. Will not be the fastest way to go through on a straight line. Who's that? Stuart Fleming goes 11th. That's a great improvement there for Team Core. He was right at the back last time round. Midfield this time. Where's Martin Palm pop through? He pops in 14th there. 3.6 seconds off the pace. No, he doesn't have any weight at all. So that's no good. And Sidnovas is pole position with 35 kilos of weight. Well, that will send out a surefire signal to him. So far, still got 4.5 minutes left to go. Eric Gillot is still out on track in P25 currently at the moment for Union Motorsport International. Their team significantly downsized compared to last season, but Gillot still team leader running through. Where's he popping? 15th there, 3.7 off the pace, just in between Palm and Hack. And ahead of Buck McNaughton, who's popped in 17th there, 6.6 off the pace, so he must have had a bit of a disaster somewhere along the line. Ehab Abbas has spun in the pit lane. I'm not quite sure what he's up to. He must be drunkardly flolloping around. But he's not even made it onto the track, so I don't quite know what he's done. Gagzella just passes through the start-finish straight to start his lap for Storm Racing Team. He has 28 kilograms of weight added on, which is surely a couple of trifles. Two temps up at the end of sector one. Gillot getting out of the way nicely indeed as he recovers back to the pits. everyone just flopping through. Adrian McNaughton's popped into second for Storm Racing team, so that's a McNaughton going in the right way up the field. Gaxella has got Spoliarek, who's on an out lap just up ahead, but he's far enough up the road to not cause an issue. And I like the way how there's lines on that corner, because it reminds me of track and field events. I feel like there should be like little Limford Christie running through, complete with lunchbox, and that's not going to help at all. Spoliarek gets out of the way for Gaxella. He runs out far too wide, two wheels on the grass. That's never going to be the fastest way through. Gaxella is just a few thousandths behind Sidnovus, as who's that popping up quite nicely? I think that was Mark Jones popping into eighth there. Gaxella definitely compromised. He comes out of the final turn, across the line he goes. Still could be quite juicy for a top five, because that's the good stuff. Sixth position, 1.1 seconds off the pace, just between Tom Ely and Martin Jones, who's popped into seventh position. So, Andreas Stankiewicz also out at the moment as well. Anthony Jones did not complete his lap. A Randall is out too, as is George Talbot. Everyone's out, so they're all going to get round and complete their lap before the clock strikes zero. Stankiewicz in P24, just popping over the line and going ninth. But Spoliarek, who we've got on track, is running out wide. As you can see, some of these corners really are biting back on the driver, and that again out wide. This is uncharacteristic here by Borna. Normally he is precision personified, but not here today. He's more like a, I was going to say a jigglypuff, but that's not what I meant to say at all. A jiggly jelly. And I wonder if Gaxella is going to pay the same respects back to Spoliarek as Spoliarek almost did to him, although Gaxella was busy going off on his own accord before he caught Spoliarek anyway. But these two, not the best of friends, and I wonder what will happen. Just 4 thousandths down at the end of Sector 2, despite running out wide and putting wheels on the grass, they let each other by on exactly the same part, but Spoliarek handles that one much better than Emmanuel. That's a much tidier exit out of the chicane. Down the home straight, one final corner to go. Let's see what Spoliarek does. Is it a load of spagol, or is it not? Second position, not quite, just under 2 tenths down, and 11 thousandths ahead of Randu Muru, who's popped into third in his independent car. Who have we got out and about? We've got, you have a Bass popping over the line. He pops in 14th position. That leaves us Aid Randall down in 29th, just coming round to complete his laps. Also got Tyrone Frith and George Talbot. George Talbot spun it out of the final corner, and he's showboating across the line, and he ends up 25th. Just a hundredth ahead of Dave Robertson. So that went all wrong at the final turn there for Georgie Porge. Aid Randall, again, another man deciding that grass is better than tarmac. I'm not quite sure on that one myself, but Randall needs to get a handle on it as he's slowly making his way through the last couple of corners here. This is the tricky one, this chicane that people are really struggling with, and that's not the racing line. So I think it's just because the car is so disabled over it, but Aid's car just doesn't look as glued to the floor as what some others are. And this track, because of its speed and its nature, everyone's oversteering and really struggling to get the car together. What's Aid do is he pops over the line. That's 22nd, 4.2 down. That wasn't bad at all, despite having some just strange racing lines. 22nd for the English Racing Knights Lords, beating the Paladins of Anthony Jones, who failed to complete his lap. Tyrone Frith is just coming round the final corner now for TTF Racing. And let's see where he pops in as the qualification session comes to a close. Again, not looking the speediest, but what can he do? 23rd, just a tenth behind Aid Randall. So that's everyone across the line. Martina Sidnovas does indeed get pole position 5 minutes before, well, after I decided that he had. Bonus Foliaric second, so that's going to be an all firework lineup on the front row. Randy Muru and Rono Muru have got a McNaughton in between. It's all brothers galore here, with Adrian McNaughton sandwiching those two. Tom Ely 6, Gaxella 7th after his mistake with Martin Jones, Tim Spur, and Andreas Stankiewicz rounding out the top 10. Wow, full packed grid of 29 drivers. I think this is going to be some extreme drama going on here today. Evening to you too, Mr. Walker, in our chat room. Welcome, welcome. I do like it when people get interactive. Makes me a little bit warm inside. So, as everyone pats themselves on the backs and goes forward to a quick warm-up session before we move into race one. Bit confused there by what Ryan Walker was just saying in the chat room. He was planning to race, but hard is buggered. Does that mean someone snapped off your penis? Ah, oh, hard drive, okay. Is no good. Hard drive. Ah, okay. I mean, automatically just thinking the filthiest. So, on your screens we have the driving standings so far. Three rounds completed. Sidnovas there with two wins, two podiums, and three top three fives out of a three possibles, and a pole, and a fastest lap. My God, he's got it all already. And he's led 32 of the 48 laps we've raced so far with 83 points. It's Martina Sidnovas stamping himself all over the place like some person in high heels. Borna Spoliarek there, just a few points behind, ahead of Gaxella from Palm. The two Murus, our Estonian friends. Paul Joseph doing a fine account of himself there for what is effectively a Division 2 driver. Adrian McNaughton leading the McNaughton charge ahead of Ehab Abbas and John Gibbons, equal on 30. 21 drivers have scored points so far. 23 have taken part in races so far, though that will suddenly change now. Although Anthony Jones and Mark Gravett failed to score last time out, so Stuart Fleming is the lowest scoring driver with 12. And big shout out to Paul Huggett. Oh yes, 14 points. That's like pretty much what he's got the entire of last season already. Team standings, 13 teams have scored so far. Toyota Motorsport IP Forge is spanking themselves all across that trophy so far, ahead of Storm Racing Team, just the odd 38 points behind. One ahead of Toyota Motorsport Mobile. So a Stormy Sam, in fact it's a Storm and Torrent. It's a Torrent Storm. Storm Racing with 81, Psycho Racing 54, Union Motorsport International getting 32 despite having a slightly smaller team for this one. PPR, oh yes, 29.05, Motorsport 24, with English Racing Knights Lords and Nocturne, and the Lords are beating the Paladins, and that's always a good little giggle to keep themselves going with. So, who's the fat ones out today? The fat ones out on the grid. Martina Sidnovas, 35 kilos. Borna with 30. Manuel Gaxella, a slightly svelte, 28, ahead of Martin Palm. Runu Muru. Brandon Muru's got 9. And just the Weight Watcher sized ballast extra for Adrian McNaughton and Paul Joseph with the old one. Of course, that's going to start becoming a little bit more intricate as the season goes on. That's just pretty much who is trumping themselves all over the standings at the moment. Welcome to Kyle in the chat room. Good to have a new face. And there is the Poznan circuit, as I said earlier on, the last circuit foot Robert Kubica raced on before he decided that gardening was going to be his forte. over 4 kilometres. We're going to be looking at 11 laps because that will be finished before the 20-minute mark is up. The 14 turns. As we say, it's definitely been the final sector that most people have been binning it. And this is the first time we visited it in GRC land. Well, we'll soon know whether we'll be going there again. And of course, we can't do this without our sponsor, IP Forge, to which I will doff my hat. Welcome Jim Clark as well to our channel. Thank you, IP Forge, for making this all possible. And of course, to our admin and cameraman, Simon Lewis, who deserves a mini round of applause. Mini, not lots. And of course, Simrace.TV. Well, I hope everyone's had an excellent weekend. I know I have. It was my birthday. I found... We left to Canterbury actually to see the cathedral there, which was quite good, but the cathedral was overshadowed by the fact that I found a place that does milkshakes where you can choose any chocolate bar or any cake or any cereal, I don't know why people want to do cereal, that you wanted to, and you could have your own personalised milkshake. So I had a Battenberg one, gorgeous. Oh, yummage. My other half had a double-decker one, which also tasted nice. Not that they got to eat it, because I might have eaten that one as well. And we went to a Mexican restaurant called Chimichanga's, and that was the only reason why we went there. It was just that we could say Chimichanga quite a lot. Yeah. Did I get pissed, says Ryan. Well, can duck swim? Nice beak. Personnel, leave the grid now. And here we are, we're through to racy time. Best of luck to everyone. We will do a run through the field. The weights are just being applied, so no skinny dipping for you guys at the front. May the union stand strong, says Eric Chilot. That sounds suspiciously like you've just come out of Russia. So, let's go through the grid. Martina Sidnovas for Turret Motorsport Mobile is on pole position. Once again, Borna Spoliarek will be starting alongside and sister team Turret Motorsport IP Forge. Third, in that beautiful green lime, Randy Muru, independent. In fact, if that car could be put into a drink, I think it would be a corduroy. Adrian Norton, fourth position for Storm Racing Team, ahead of sister team mate Runo Muru for Storm Racing. I'm sure there's a distinction in there somewhere. Tommy Lee, sixth for Nocturne. I wonder if I could use the words nocturnal emissions for his exhaust. Manuel Gaxella, seventh for Storm Racing Team, eighth. Martin Jones, courtesy car. Good effort there by Martin Jones. That is suspiciously hand the gandery, that livery. Ninth, Tim Spurn, Psycho Racing. Tim Spurn. Spurn! Adrian Stankiewicz, 10th for Torrent Motorsports Osiris. 11th, Mark Jones for Azure Racing. Good effort. Ilge Brocato, 12th for Torrent Motorsport Mobile, out of position from traffic. PPR Rockstar, Barry Ward, 13th. So, unfortunately pipped towards the end there by several cars. Ian Bass, 14th for Storm Racing. 15th, Paul Joseph, Union Motorsport International, top union guy. 16th, Stuart Fleming, much better shown for him in Team Core. Definitely must have lubed that one out. John Gibbon, 17th for Psycho Racing. Disappointingly down the order there for John, I'd have thought. Mike Ward for English Racing Night Paladins, looking to one up the Lords. I'm sure the vicar that I was at Canterbury Cathedral said that about some choir boys earlier. Martin Palm, 19th for Turret Motorsport IP Forge, again way down the field. Eric Gillot, 20th for Union Motorsports International. 21st, Jan Hack. Oh yes, 22nd, Aid Randall, English Racing Knights Lords.
Hallelujah.
23rd, Tyrone Friff, the TTF's first race of the season. 24th, Mark McNaughton, must have been in trouble there in his independent. 25th, Stephen Boniface, welcome back. One of our faithful regulars, good to see you on track, mate. Paul Huggett, PPR Rockstar, 26th, rocking it out. 27th, George Talbot for 05 Motorsports. 28th, the second old rubbery roo for Dave Robertson. And Anthony Jones, who failed to complete his lap, starts 29th and last for the Paladins. And they are just plopping themselves onto the grid now. Someone's out of position. I know they're getting themselves sorted now. But as the back of the field decide to sort themselves out, here come the lights. Round two for GRC here at Poznan is about to go. Sitnova's off to a good start despite having a bit of a dodge. Someone screws. Adrian McNaughton there is almost stuck in gear by the looks of it. I wonder if he left his speedometer on or something like that, because he's dropping down the field like a stone. But Sidnova's leads from Spoljaric, Muru, Ely, Muru, Gaxella, Jones, Stankovicius up to 8th. They're doing a great start, as is Brocalo, who's just about to overtake him by going through the middle. Everyone else is kind of going through. Adrian McNaughton drops down to 22nd position. A disaster there for the Storm Racing team. 23rd now as Stuart Fleming goes around the outside. Not the best start for him at all. Next time, pedal equals good, as Sidnovas leads the way from Spoljaric. And someone is off at the back there. Oh, there's a couple of people off. Tim Spurs facing the wrong way for Psycho Racing. Down in, well, 23rd, 25th, 26th. Oh, down. Stuart Fleming off the track as well. So obviously he's bunked his load already. Tim Spur rejoins back in 29th from last position, so that's not a good one for him. Sidnovas continues on his way from Spoljaric, Muru and Tom Ely now into 4th, but he's just been displaced by Gaxella side by side for 4th and 5th position. Gaxella goes through for Storm Racing team, and Tom Ely there, someone's flashing their lights, a little bit excitable. It's probably because Gaxella's slightly jumping the track there through the chicane. Side by side, who is that? Thank you, Vicious and Jones for 8th and 9th positions. Tyrant Motorsport Osiris versus Gurdjieff. I'm sure they're in their own teams, I just don't have a skin. Martin Jones fancy and a look back through, but nothing doing round there. So, the end of lap 1. Martina Sidnova's lead by just under a second from Borna Spoljaric. Randy Muru's third, got Emmanuel Gaxella right on his tail. And Tommy sits in 5 from Reynu Muru. Ilja Brocalo up to 7th from a great start. Stankovicius, Martin Jones, Barry Ward up to 10th has just got round Martin Palm, who's from 19th on the grid, suddenly finds himself 11th. So that's a fantastic start there for him. Mark Jones is 12th. John Gibbons, George Talbot, Eric Gillot. You have a Bass. Adrian McNaughton just passing everything, as Reynu Muru and Manuel Gaxella continue to battle away. Gaxella pinching himself all over the rear of Muru. It looks like he's faster, but he's just not got a way of getting through. Everyone else still running strongly, although Anthony Jones almost facing the grassy knolls of the edge of the track right down the back of the field. Gaxella's taking some interesting lines. I think he's taking this whole must keep at least one wheel on the black stuff to the extreme, because it doesn't look like he's really taking it well. I feel he's slightly shortcutting, but that might just be me. Muru is not, however, but he is losing out to Borna Spoljaric, who is closing down Sidnovas. Who's that going down the field? No one, don't mind me, it's just pop back. So yep, 2.2 seconds now between Sidnovas and Randy Muru as the leading duo start to pull away. Muru is starting to bottle call cut Tom Ely, his brother, and Ilja Brocalo as well, as Borna Spoljaric sets the fastest lap of the race. Stankovicius then leads group 3 with Jones, Palm, Ward, Mark Jones, and George Talbot, who suddenly found himself in 13th position from the back of the grid. Someone's off the track, that's Mark Jones in 12th position for Adura Racing. proper off-road rallying. He's just getting going again as Eric Gillot and John Gibbons go side by side round turns 1 and 2. Fantastic action between them. Mark Jones rejoins. He's going to have to let Paul Joseph through. I think Adrian Randall was off just behind him too, doing a double dare, do and die. Maybe if your car's purple, you've got to go off down at turn 2. Because they're all going for it there if they're in a purple car. Adrian Randall rejoins in 20th, just behind Tyrone Frith. Adrian McNaughton's out with a suspension failure, so I'm not sure what he's done apart from Binnett. Who else have we got going on? Tom Ely now on the back of Gaczella. Great battle going on right at the back of the field as well, as Mike Ward, Anthony Jones and Tim Spurr all negotiated Paul Huggett, which they all now have, but the four of them, it was all starting to look like the last lap for 8th position in an F1 race as they scrabble amongst themselves. Boliarik though continues to keep a watching brief over Sidnovas for the lead. 2.4 now the gap back to Randu Muru. Some of the parts around Randu truly Muru is about right, Mr. Cameraman, as he whispers in my ears in a giggly way. But Tom Ely is the one that is going to be screwed, because Renu Muru is having a look down into turn 1. Storm versus Nocturne. You could have a nocturnal storm. And Renu has got it through. Tom Ely gives him plenty of room around the outside, then comes back to squeeze him on the exit. Now they have got wheels up against each other. Plenty of rubbing going on. Maybe they should need that Durex car involved, because one of them could end up pregnant as they come down to the next couple of corners. But Tom Ely keeps the position from Renu for now. Good driving by the pair of them. They knew exactly how much of a liberty they could take with each other before it would all go horribly wrong. Ricardo clinging on, and Stanky Fisher is actually closing in on them. So Martin Palm now up to 9th, having disposed of Martin Jones. The two Martins going well. Once again, Gaczella hustling Muru. Muru is making that green car not only work to his advantage, because it's probably making Emmanuel's eyes bleed, but he's also making it one fat ass. Oh, Barry Ward's off the track in 15th position. I think he's crashed and out. Let me have a little look. He was battling with George Talbot. I wonder if something happened there. Oh, yeah. Barry Ward there being clouted by George Talbot, but of his own accord there. But Barry back up in 20th position. Gaczella is passed then. Randu Muru, good move, as you saw on your screens. Anthony Jones has just crashed out from English Racing Knights Paladins. And that was a bizarre one, because he just seemed to drive off into the trees. He didn't even hit a barrier. So Anthony Jones there obviously just deciding, you know what, this is a disaster. Leave it alone. Briccalo versus Renu Muru for 6th and 7th position into turn 1. Muru's gone from attacking to defensive in one fell swoop, and down to 7th he goes. Ildra Briccalo picks him off. And that is all good there. Here comes Spoliarik though on Sidnovas. And Spoliarik is going to have a go through. Sidnovas does the old switcheroo to try and get back through, and it's not worked. Spoliarik keeps the lead then. And Sidnovas goes down to 2nd, the first time he's really been challenged. Once he's got to the lead of a race this season so far, and Spoliarik takes it. Good and aggressive moves by the pair of them, but respectful enough not to take each other off. Helston was just saying in the chat room, don't be surprised if they take each other off on the first lap in some ways, Borner and Gaczella. But Borner and Gaczella are still going in first and third position. Sidnova's getting very leery around some of these corners. So, obviously he's got 35 kilograms of weight attached to his car, so maybe that is what is tricking him. Randu Muru still keeping in fourth, with Ely holding up Briccalo and Renu Muru. Stanky Vicious is about to close on that, as is Martin Palm. Martin Jones is 10, George Talbot 11 all on his own. Eric Gillot has got John Gibbons, Ehab Abbas behind him. Mark Jones running well for 15th now in the Giro Racing. Now he's back on track. Jan Hack's got Paul Joseph all over the back of him for 16th and 17th place. As Tyrone Frith has recovering Barry Ward for 18th and 19th. Dave Robertson on his debut running in 20th in a points-paying position at the moment. So that's all looking good as Barry Ward just overtakes Tyrone Frith for 18th down the straight. Good move there by Barry. Tyrone fancying to go back through again, but that would require something. Oh, Mike Ward's out. 25th position, he's crashed it. And that was into the chicane. Oh, well, coming out of the chicane, actually, and just steering off into the area. So, slowly dropping like flies. And Stephen Boniface must have been in trouble somewhere because he's splattered in last, a whole minute off the pace. So, that's no good for him either. So, field slowly spreading out in small clumps on lap 5 of 11. Not quite the hot-ass racing that we had last week out, but this is still looking good as here comes Tom Ely. That was an interesting lunge-a-leaner, but didn't quite work out as Tom Ely decides that he wanted to stick his nose right in. That's not helped him out for that corner, and he's straight from being on the aggressive to the defensive, as there's a great little four-car train going on right behind these as well. So you've got Muru, Ely and Brocalo all having it out with each other. In fact, they're having it off with each other. That would be a completely different show, one that we would not be able to show, at least until another 6 minutes passed in the UK time period. As Muru, Ely and Brocalo come onto the home straight, and Brocalo a much better line on Ely as they come down the home straight. Turn 1 does appear to be the place to do it. Ely is giving him plenty of room. Or is he? Very, very close indeed. Brocalo pushes him right the way out to the outside there, but holds the position. Well, my goodness. At least Tomini didn't eat a fat dinner, because I don't think there would have been any other room for him. Reino Muru is there, has gone way off wide. Where was that? Come back. You're not going on some kind of Eurovision tour. And unfortunately, Muru there down to fifth position. Brocalo has two cars in half a lap. Randu straight on the attack to try and regain his position. That was a unforced error there, pretty much all on his own. The other two were busy squabbling with each other and he went and buggered it up. So Ilja out to fourth for Toyota Motorsport Mobile, Randy Muro down to fifth, sixth for Ely in the Nocturne car, and he's straight onto Randy because that was who he was attacking to begin with. So he needs to sort that one out. We should drop back down to the 7, 8, 9, 10 little squabble that's going on. Stankovicius is leading that one with Reino Muru, so Muru's are right in the thick of it here. Martin Palm still recovering from 19th on the grid. He's made up 10 positions already, which is fantastic in 6 laps. Smoke being locked up there, but everyone's got through that corner okay. And Martin Jones doing a great job in 10th position. Just clinging onto the back of this, he deserves a lot of credit for that. He's not always up in the top 10, but he's doing good today. Just about clinging on, and Muru there. Oh, Martin Palm, scary, scary stuff out of the exit there as Reino up onto the back of Stankovicius as they come across the start-finish line. Does he feel brave enough to have a look into turn one? He's left it very, very late. Stankovicius, where are you going, my friend? And round she goes! Andreas Stankovicius almost scared off the road there by Reino Muru. Is just rejoining in not the safest ways, and George Talbot there has gone off, I think, in scaredness of watching Stankovicius come back on. Is Eric Chalot going to fancy a go at this in the Union Motorsport International car? I don't think he's got enough of a run on George to do it. George is not going to need that though, because oh, he just about hangs on around the outside. That wasn't necessarily a racing line, but he still managed to bungle his way through it. Martin Palm has been overtaken by Mark Jones though, as Mark Jones is having a go at Reino Muru too. He's suddenly gone from 10th to 8th, and now he's fancying a look at 7th there. Great stuff here by Martin Jones, as he is now top Martin of the brigade. Stephen Boniface just crashed out from 26th and last position. Tyrone Frith's facing the wrong way in 24th, so there's all kinds of drama going on at the back of the field. However, there is still good stuff going on up front as Spoliarik continues to lead Sidnovis. Gaxella's closing in on the pair of them. Then there's a great scrap for 4, 5 and 6 between Brocalo, Randu Muru and Tom Ely. Tom Ely is shadowing Randu Muru quite literally round this final corner. I think if he gets a good run out of this, he will have a good run down the straight. But no, he didn't actually. Randu got much better exit out of the final corner. I don't think that's going to happen at all. However, Martin Jones has got a much better run than Rainer Muru. Muru goes defensive down into turn one. Can Martin Jones go round the outside? I think he can, because Muru's got two light wheels on the curb, and that's not going to give him the best purchase round this long, long, long sweeping 180 corner. Martin Palm is just getting a double slipstream off the pair of them, and maybe Martin Jones will find himself shuffled to the outside. Indeed he does. Martin Palm's going to try and do the pair of them in one corner. That can only either be a do or die effort. He's going to be far too deep, and Muru takes it back through again. Martin Jones is going to try and yoink the place back through. This is good stuff here by Martin Palm as he clings on around the outside, better than a floater in a bog, as they come screaming around the last little corner there, and somehow he's got round Martin Jones. Jones fancying another back run back through again. There's only so many switcheroos you can do in one fell swoop, and that's not worked out there in the end there for Martin Jones. But Martin Palm up to 8th position, getting his place back through again. Good action and good respectful stuff, no contact really between a lot of them. Stankovicius on his own now in 10th has pulled clear of George Talbot, with Gillot and Ibas 12 and 13, Mark Jones 14, then Gibbons, Paul Joseph, Barry Ward, Dave Robertson now up to 18th, ahead of Jan Hack and Tim Spur, who are still recovering. Lots of damaged cars towards the back of the field. And look at this battle for the lead. Borna Spoljarić has fallen behind Sidnovis. When did that happen? It must have happened in the last lap. Look at Sidnovis going so defensive with two laps still to go for Spoljarić. Not able to do anything but just follow in the slipstream. Didn't even feel like he could pull out and have a go around the outside. And don't forget, the Godzilla man himself, Emmanuel Gaxella, is about to get his monster on as they come round these first few corners. And this is going to be an absolute firework finale. It's been a slow burner up front, but my goodness, I think we're here for piece de resistance round these final couple of corners, as there's a change of position. George Talbot's fallen behind Eric Gillot for 11th and 12th off your screens. But look at everything kicking off up front, as we seem to have got people into like little trios. Oh, actually, let's go back to 12 and 13, because George Talbot's trying to go around the outside of Eric Gillot. That's not going to work round there, mate. Gillot closes the door. Union Motorsports versus 05 Motorsports. And Eric's got it, as Martin Jones has retaken Martin Palm for 8th and 9th position, although Martin Jones needs spinning once he's done so, but he's just about held the position. Gillot holds off Talbot then, with Abbas and Jones keeping a very close watching brief. Back up front though, here comes Spoljarić versus Sidnovis. That chicane, not the best place to have a go. Almost like you've got to pressure someone into doing the mistake. And look at Borna just shadowing everything. If he can just get it right round this final corner. He's taken a tighter line. Sidnovis runs out slightly. That's not going to help at all. Spoljarić is going to go in a quick dip in for the slipstream. He's practically pushing the car down the straightaway. And he can leave it to the last minute and posh out. Is Sidnovis going to go defensive? Yes, he is. Can Spoljarić go round the outside? There may be good purchase there. Sidnovis locks up a wheel. But he holds the position. Spoljarić keeps a watching brief in second. Gaxella's clinging on, although he'd done the faster lap of the three last time round, but literally, oh no, he didn't actually. I talk more pastrami than anyone else as they come flying through, but just literally a couple of attempts between the lot of them. Brocalo still holding off Muru and Ely for 4, 5, and 6. As someone's off the track, George Talbot's off the track and has dropped down to 14th in his 05 Motorsports, so it's not going well for him in the latter stages. But this is the last lap. If it's going to happen, it's got to happen now. Sidnovis, Spoljarić, Gaxella, which one of these three is going to take home the trophy for round one of this evening's entertainment. Sid Novus waited for the right opportunity until a couple of laps ago to make his riposte on Borna. Can he now cling on round this final sector? I sort of feel that actually turn one is one of the best opportunities to overtake. And Spoliarik's running out wide, and that I think is just going to help it now go to Sid Novus, because Spoliarik's now having to look in his rear instead of up front, because Gaczela is hassling the back of the TMO driver's bumper. And Sid Novus, one corner to go, don't bugger it up here, and he's got it. He had it at the start, he let it go, but he waited for his right opportunity and got it back. And with a little gink out from his rear wheels, Martina Sid Novus takes round one here at Poznan this evening, ahead of Borna Spoliarik, second, who lost it with two laps to go, third to Emmanuel Gaczela, who spins across the line, fourth, Phil Giapercarlo, held off Randu Muru for five, Tom Ely gets six, Reinu Muru slots in seventh, Martin Jones beats home Martin Palm for Battle of the Martins, eighth and ninth positions, Andreas Stankiewicz, a scrappy tenth, but that'll do him for now. Eric Chilot, a great 11th position for him. We have a Bass 12th, Mark Jones 13th, held off George Talbot in 14th, who binned it on the last lap. 15th, Paul Joseph, good points for him still. John Gibbons, an anonymous 16th for Psycho Racing. Barry Ward, a recovering 17th for PPR Rockstar. 18th will go to Dave Robertson, great debut there, beating home Tim Spur by 200ths of a second. Great finish there, as Tim Spur is the second Psycho Racing car. Jan Hack scores the final point, 50 seconds off the pace. No points for Ode Randall, who we saw lose it at the very beginning of the race. Mark McNaughton was in trouble early on too. Stuart Fleming fell, well, he got limp towards the end for Team Core. Tyrone Frith for TTF, 24th position. Paul Huggett unlapped in 25th place. That's great to see Huggy on the lead lap as he continues to improve his race craft. Retirements, Stephen Boniface, Mike Ward, Anthony Jones and Adrian McNaughton all putting it either into the kitty litter or into the stone walls. 25 finishes. Well, an interesting opening account here at Poznan for GRC. Thanks to IP Forge for sponsoring this evening's entertainment. I think that sets things up quite nicely. Round two, we all get going in the same order that we finished him. And that potentially leaves us with the three drivers who are really romping it away in that round. Just pick up where they left off for round two here at GRC. So, if you're watching this and you're thinking, actually, this is pretty damn good, I need to get involved, you need to pop across to rfgrc.co.uk, sign yourselves up, and just damn well do it. Everyone. Randy Murray says, is my skin bright enough? I tell you what. If your skin was any brighter, you'd need to go on a sunbed, mate. What did everyone in the chat room think of that? I'd like to know your opinions. I can just lightly whore myself out. Not only do we have GRC here on Monday evenings from 8:15 at the end of this month, the last weekend, I will be attempting a record-breaking 24-hour broadcast. Oh yes. With, of course, cameraman extraordinaire Simon Milosh. Lovingly coughing in my ear, as if to say, damn well, don't forget me. I'm not sure, are you doing a whole 24 hours? I don't think you should. Oh God, he says he believes so. Right, we're takeaway bingoing each other, I think. with that one. So yes, we'll be having a good old giggle on that. Of course, that will be on Simrace.TV. Get to hear back whether it will actually be an official world record or not. I did send off something to ask to old Guinness just to see whether or not they will include it. Annoyingly, actually, I do have a friend that is a world record holder, and it's for the most amount of mince pies eaten in, I think it's 90 seconds. But Guinness Book of World Records, which is a bit funny because it's sponsored by Guinness, have removed all food world records because they don't want to encourage obesity. But they're quite happy to sponsor the World Book of World Records for drinking reasons. Come on. Idiots. Just because I can eat like 5 mince pies in a minute doesn't mean that I'm going to be clinically obese. Depends how long I've been trying it for, maybe. We'll see. Yeah, I look forward to seeing you all there. And of course, we've got plenty of GRC action for you all. For you all. I'm starting to sound like everyone in my fish and chip shop. Next week we've got Adelaide. It's going to be, I think that will be classic. That will, I love the Adelaide circuit. Great stuff. That's on the 26th of March. Then the 2nd of April we're at Live Glen. Who are? Then we're off to Mexico on the 16th. The A1 Ring in Austria on the 23rd of April. Snotterton, as I like to call it, on the 30th of April. Then rounding off with a little bit of Monza on the 7th of May. So nice 8 rounds. One of the best reasons for GRC is that you don't necessarily have to devote millions and millions and millions of hours of your time. It's nice short seasons. And definitely R Factor 1 still the way to go so far. Anyone that's tried R Factor 2, I think, will support you on that decision. Little bits from the chat room of the drivers here. Eric Gillot just talking about everyone must make sure that they he's saying I will try and stay on the tarmac next race. We've done well last time, mate. Don't worry. Tommy Lee saying I've only just realised that the markers are on the other side of the track. Mark Jones, what brake markers? Never seen them. One of the best things about GRC is the fact that damn good community. So feel the love, feel the love. Trying to think what else exciting has been going on these days, actually. No, I've had quite a boring life of late. Can't even think of any weird customers I've had at work. You ever think? I'm here for beer while I think. Maybe that will stir up something. Oh, I'll tell you what, I've only just watched the Inbetweeners movie last night, actually, for the first time. That is awesome. Love that film. The dance is pretty cool. That dance reminds me a little bit of my extent of dancing, to be fair. So, that was pretty awesome. What else did I get for my birthday? I got Mario Party 9. Oh, yes. Got to do some Wii loving. And because Game and GameStation are all like closing down, and although they're calling it a spring clear out sale, but you blatantly know that actually it's just a deal, we're all dead. Non-essential personnel leave the grid now. I got quite a good few things. I got Rock Band 2 for a couple of quid. That was quite good. The Avatar game for $2.99. That was a riot. And I've not long just got into the PSP, because it's now so cheap and cheerful now that the PS Vita has come out. So I've been getting loads of those games for a couple of quid as well. So I think if anyone's never been on portable gamings before, if you stay like a console behind, PSP games are actually pretty damn good. And yeah, I've been enjoying going through that back catalogue on the Jeep. So here we are in the formation lap, just getting going. And Martina Sidnova's pole position once again, ahead of Borna Spoliarek, who will be starting alongside Emmanuel Gaczela, is third, ahead of Ilja Bregalo, fourth position at Motorsports, 1, 2, and 4. Randy Murray, fifth position. Tom Ely, sixth, top nocturne. Oh, John Gibbons has just left the game.